Welcome. My name is Brittany Timberlake, and it is wonderful that you are here to join me for your yin practice. This is yin yoga for hot summer nights because we are going to stay super low to the ground, getting as cool as possible, trying to balance out some of that yang heated energy that we can experience in the summer. We're not going to need any props for this practice other than a wall. So we'll start with legs up the wall. So we'll make our way there now. And just coming up to the wall, it's never very pretty, just swinging those legs up. Taking your time to wiggle around, get comfortable. You could have the legs and the feet close together, or you might feel more comfortable with the legs a little bit wider. The feet could be pointing out or in. And just letting the arms rest comfortably by your side. You might like to close your eyes. Starting to turn your awareness inside. Feeling the temperature of the warm air on your skin. Noticing where the heels make contact with the wall. Noticing where the back of the skull is resting on the floor. Allowing there to be a heaviness to the shoulders. A heaviness to the pelvis. Arms and hands are soft. Allowing yourself to fully arrive and giving yourself permission to settle into stillness and silence. slowly. Just bring a little bit of movement into the feet and the ankles. Like a point and flex the feet. And we'll move into a figure four with the legs up the wall on the right side. Bending the right knee, we'll take the right ankle and place it on top of the left thigh. You could stay right here. This might be enough of a sensation for you through the outer right hip, glute, IT band. Or you could start to bend the left knee and just walk the left foot down the wall. It's going to draw the right leg in closer towards your torso. And you could play with shifting the right knee a little bit to the right or to the left. Just small little movements could change what you're feeling in the targeted areas. So finding that bittersweet spot. And then we'll hang out here for some time. Relaxing your jaw. Relaxing the space between your eyebrows. Returning to the breath. Continually coming back to the present moment. Slowly release from figure four, extending the left leg up the wall. And then releasing the right leg up the wall. Just letting the legs shake out. And we'll hug both knees in towards the chest. Massaging the lower back into the floor. Extend both legs back up. We're moving into figure four on the left side. Bending the left knee. The left ankle comes to rest somewhere on the right thigh. Staying here or walking the right foot down the wall. So we're continuing to open up through the hips and the legs, but we're also getting the added benefit of allowing any blood or lymph that's collected in the feet, ankles, allowing that to drain back down towards the heart. And this might be a nice time to check in with where the mind goes when we become still and when we become quiet. taking your time to release. Never any rush. Extending both legs back up the wall, giving them a final shake, point and flex. And we'll draw the knees in to the chest. Give yourself another squeeze. And then we'll just roll over onto our left side and just hang out in a fetal shape for a few breaths before we transition up. So moving very slowly, we're going to come into Sphinx on our bellies. We'll take our elbows underneath our shoulders. You can have your head hanging back or more neutral or coming forward. The legs can be close together or wide apart. And the entire lower body relaxes as we compress the lower spine. And open up through the front of the body, the abdomen. Finding a sense of ease and calm. Cooling down the body, cooling down the mind. mindfully and slowly releasing. Just letting the elbows wing out to the sides, resting your forehead on stacked hands. Noticing the sensations that you're feeling in through the lower back. We're going to transition onto our backs. We're going to take the path of least resistance just by rolling over right onto our backs. Continuing to stay very low to the ground. We'll hug the knees in and give yourself a little squeeze, a hug. We'll take the feet down onto the floor near the bum. And just let the knees fall out to the sides, the soles of the feet come together. And as we take this butterfly shape with the legs, you could have the feet close towards you or further away, you can choose. You might like to have one hand resting on your heart and one on your belly. Feeling the chest and the belly rise and fall with each breath in and out.
over the next few breaths, we'll transition. You can take your hands and help the legs to close. Just letting the knees sway a little bit from side to side. We'll take our arms out into a T shape. We'll shift the hips a little bit to the right, allowing the knees to fall to the left. You could always take the right leg and wrap it around the bottom, twisting your roots. Your next breath out, we'll use the core to help draw the legs back to center. Shifting the hips a little bit to the left. And then allowing the knees, either stacked or twisted, to fall to the right. releasing from the twist, making any other movements that you might like to make before we come into our final corpse pose. And I invite you to take up a lot of space, letting the legs and the arms come out wide. I don't know about you, but my floor feels nice and cool. I'm just taking these final moments to fully rest. Allow healing to take place on a deep level. Allow the breath to become a little bit deeper and longer, bringing movement into your fingers and toes, rolling out the wrists and the ankles. We'll bend the knees, bring the knees into the chest for one last squeeze. Rolling over onto one side. Top hand helps to press you all the way up to a seat. Bring our hands together at our heart. Soft gaze. Oh, my dear friends, I hope that your body and your mind feels a little bit cooler, calmer, and that if you're heading on to bed, I hope that you have a great sleep. Namaste.